Welcome to the Recon Trader. In today's video, I will show you how to set up and by the end of the video, how to deploy a profitable CoinRoll automated crypto trading bot strategy that utilizes TradingView alerts to execute both the buy and the sell side of the actual strategy. And if you're not familiar with CoinRoll, it is basically a platform that allows you to create your own automated rule-based strategies. It's the if this, then this, or then that type strategy that most of us day traders actually use in our day trading. So it's extremely simple and straightforward to configure, even if you're new to setting up crypto trading bots. Now, if you're new to CoinRoll, you can actually get started for free, and that will give you 2 live rules and 2 demo rules. And the demo rules will basically allow you to deploy your strategies to demo trading before you deploy them to live fire, and so you can really test them out and see if you have a valid strategy. And to get started for free today, I will drop a link in the description down below. Now, after you join the CoinRoll platform, you will want to connect your exchange to the CoinRoll platform. You don't actually send any money to CoinRoll. You use API keys from your exchange in order to execute buy and sell orders, so your money stays on your exchange and is as secure as it can be when being held on an exchange. And to do that, you just simply click on exchanges over here on the left-hand side of the screen. You would select your exchange, give it a click, and then they have a tutorial on how to go about setting up your API keys, so I'm not going to do a deep dive into that. You can simply follow their guide, and that will help you get your exchange connected to CoinRoll. So, now that you have your exchange connected to CoinRoll, you're ready to set up your first rule. So you just come over here to the button that says Create Rule, give that a click. And the first thing you need to do to create a new rule is select either demo exchange for the demo trading or your exchange that you actually connected via the API keys. In this case, I am going to select my Binance US exchange and give that a click. Now I'm ready to actually get started with the configuration of the parameters for this strategy. And the first step is my if event. I need the if this happens, then buy or sell or whatever. And so in this case, my if event will be if, and I'm going to select TradingView signal. And so I just scroll down to where it says TradingView signal, give that a click. And the TradingView signal is going to be based on a strategy I created. So if we jump over here to TradingView, you will see I'm on the chart for ETH USDT on the 4-hour candles, and the strategy I will be using is my Recon Price Cross EMA RSI, and that's a strategy that I configured using the TradingView Pine Editor down here at the bottom of the screen. If we give that a click, you can actually see the code I created for this strategy. Now, I did upload a video recently on how to create this strategy, so if you missed that video, first of all, you probably want to shoot that subscribe button so you don't miss future videos, but I will drop a link into the description down below so you can check out how I actually went about configuring this strategy using the TradingView Pine Editor. And so how this particular strategy is designed to operate is it is looking for the price to cross above my EMA, my moving average, and at the same time have a RSI level above a certain predetermined level. In this case, for me, it's 55 on the RSI. Now, the EMA is a trend-based indicator, so I'm looking for perhaps a reversal in a trend. In addition to the RSI is a momentum-based indicator, and so by having that RSI level over 55, in theory would indicate the momentum is heading up in my direction. And so if we take a look right here at this first little highlighted bubble, you can see where the price crosses over my EMA line, which is this green and red line. However, I don't get my entry on the next candle. The strategy is configured to operate on the close of candles, but I don't get my entry right away until the RSI actually gets above the yellow line down here, which is the 55 level, and that would be in line with this candle. As you can see, it actually jumps above the 55 level on this candle, and therefore I get my entry. Now on the flip side, the exit is set up for when the price crosses down below the EMA and at the same time is below the 55 level on the RSI. So kind of just the opposite of the entry is my exit. And I'm still working on this strategy, but I'm willing to deploy it to live fire today, because for me, live fire is the best way to put these strategies to the test. So I'm going to do that. I don't necessarily recommend that for everyone, but my risk tolerance is more than likely very different than most of your risk tolerance. So I'm willing to go ahead and give this a shot. And so you can see if we entered over back here and exited up here, I believe that was around a 3% profit. Now on the next bubble over here, we can see we get another entry when the price does cross above this moving average line. We again end up having to wait for the RSI to catch up, which does show momentum is heading up. And then we enter and end up exiting when the price finally rolls over and crosses back down below. And I believe this one is around a 4% profit. Now, what I do like about creating strategies on TradingView is you're able to actually come down here to Strategy Tester, and you can basically backtest this strategy during a certain time frame and see how the strategy would have performed. And so if we take a look at the strategy tester, you can see based on the current settings for this strategy, my net profit would have been around 2,600% versus just a buy and hold return of 1,400%. And so this strategy would be outperforming the buy and hold strategy by about 1,200. Now I know how to actually improve this strategy a little bit. So we'll jump back over here to the settings for my actual indicator, and we'll give the settings button a click, and I'm going to take the length of my EMA. I'm going to change that to 50. You can see the source is always the close of the candle. For me, that is confirmation when the candle closes. My RSI period is 9. The RSI level is 55, as I mentioned earlier. And then my backtest date range is basically the beginning of cryptocurrency, because I want to go back as far as I can. And then, of course, I have a stop loss set. And if you're new to my videos, then basically I believe you should have a stop loss anytime you enter a trade. Not using a stop loss when trading is a lot like going into battle without armor. Eventually, you're going to get killed. And in this case, my stop loss is set at 9, which equals 9%. So now I can give OK a click. And then we'll jump back over here to the strategy tester. And you can see that we improved to 5,200%, and my max drawdown actually improved as well. It's only around 38, almost 40%. Now that is a little on the high side. I typically shoot for somewhere between 25 to 35%. And if we look down here at profit factor, it's just over 2. Anything over 1 is considered acceptable. Anything over 2 is considered good. However, my Sharpe ratio is pretty low. It's under 1, and 1 is considered acceptable. So I would like to see that get higher, but as I said, I'm still testing this strategy out. So I will be deploying this bot anyway today with these current settings. Now, if we scroll on down a little, we can see that the percent profitable is only 30%. So for a lot of you out there, you might not be able to handle 70% loss rate. I can. I'm accustomed to being somewhere between 30 to 40% for a win rate. To me, is typically acceptable. And then the last thing I want to look at is kind of like my risk versus reward ratio. And I'm looking at a 1 to 4.5 risk versus reward ratio, which basically means I only have to be right over 25% of the time to actually be profitable. So that is why I can have such a low win rate and still be extremely profitable. Now, if you don't think you're up for creating your own strategy, you can come up here to indicators, give that a click, and you can search for a strategy. And CoinRule actually has a bunch of strategies they already have pre-configured that you could actually use and test out. As you can see in blue, it says CoinRule. These are all strategies that they have that are being used apparently on the platform. I've not done any recon on these. So you will need to do your own recon if you decide to use any of these strategies. But you could pick one, add it to your chart by clicking on the strategy. You can see where its buy and entry levels will be at. This is a scalping strategy. And if we jump over to the strategy tester, we can see that this strategy would be up 104%, which is nowhere close to the 5,200% of the strategy I was using, but it's still a winning strategy nonetheless. Your max drawdown is a lot less. It's only 19%, and the win rate is actually 73, almost 74%. So this might be easier for someone who's new to trading to stomach rather than a 30% win rate. However, you certainly don't outperform buy and hold. And for me, that's what I'm looking to do with my trading, is to outperform just simply buying and holding. So that's enough jawjacking. Let's get this automated bot configured. So we'll jump back over here to Coin Rule. And so we have the if event, TradingView alert is a buy. And so I give this a click and select buy. Next, I need an action. So I come over here to action and give that a click. And now I have my then buy, and I need to give this strategy some ammo. So I'll give it $500 to work with. And now I need to select the coin I actually want it to trade. In this case, we will be using ETH, just like the chart I showed you. And last, I need to select the wallet to actually have the funds taken from to execute this buy. And it will be the USDT wallet. And I will select market order for the order type. Now I need to configure the sell side for this strategy. So I click on operator, and now I can configure the and then portion of this strategy. So if, and in this case, it's going to be TradingView signal is a sell. Now again, we need the action. So we'll click on action. And so now it will sell. And in this case, I want it to sell 100% of amount bought of, and in this case, again, it's going to be ETH. And then we'll have those funds put back into the USDT wallet, and it will execute as a market order. And so that's pretty much it for configuring the strategy. I have the if event, which is TradingView signal is a buy, then buy $500 of ETH with my USDT wallet at a market order. And then if TradingView signal is a sell, then sell 100% of ETH to my USDT wallet as a market order. Now we just need to configure execute, and that is start immediately. And you can actually select a time or date you want to actually start this strategy. However, I will be starting it immediately, and I want it to execute. I'm just going to pick a random number. We'll say 999 times in total. And then the last thing I need to do is actually name this strategy, and we'll name it price cross EMA RSI, which is basically the strategy that I configured. And we'll click on launch, and we get a quick recap of the actual strategy. And then this is important. You need to go and create a TradingView alert, and you will need this webhook and this message. So we will copy the webhook first, and I'll jump back over here to TradingView, and I need to create an alert. And so I just click on alert where the little alarm clock is. And now I need to select a condition. In this case, the condition is going to be my strategy, which was the recon price cross EMA RSI. And expiration time, I actually want it to be open-ended. And then the alert actions is show a pop-up. I typically have my alerts pop up on my screen. They typically send me an email. And then where it says webhook, I need to paste in the webhook. So I just click paste. And that will put in the webhook for me. And I typically like to name my alerts so when I get the email or the pop-up comes on the screen, I kind of have an idea of what the alert is for. And as I speak, there's an alert that popped up on my screen. And so we'll name this one EMA Coin Rule. And now I need the message to actually execute both the buy and the sell side. So I will jump back over to Coin Rule. And under message, I'll give copy a click, and I copy it to the clipboard. Jump back over here to TradingView to and paste that into the message and click create. And I can jump over here to the alarm clock on the right hand side of the screen, give that a click, and we can confirm that the alert is live and active over here in my alerts. So we'll jump back over here to Coin Rule and give launch a click, and the rule has been created. And you can see the status of this particular rule is live. So now we just sit back and wait and let the bot do its work. So With that being said, I will do an update video in the near future on how this bot is actually performing, so now would be a good time to shoot that subscribe button. If you like this video, do me a favor, spike a like. If you have any questions or comments, drop those in the comment section down below. And I will drop a link to CoinRule in the description down below. So, in closing, remember, never send your money into battle without first doing your recon. See you in the next video.